There is no finer compilation album, really, in Canada that comes courtesy of Neverending White Lights. Joining us right now is Daniel from the band. What's going on?
How's it going, man?
Good, man. How you doing?
Very well, very well.
Now, where to begin? I mean, Julie, you do the first question.
Thank
because
you,
I know you're,
Barry.
You're a big fan.
I am a big fan. I do love your song,
thank
The
you,
Grace.
Thank you.
And what inspired you?
Well, you know what, to make the record, it was sort of something that I thought everybody needed, you know, in terms of like something different, just not releasing a record that was sort of just a mediocre alternative band, you know, doing the same old thing. So the inspiration for Never Any White Lights was to just do something very creative and different and sort of showcase, you know, different artists outside of their environment.
How hard was it to hook up with everyone for the recording process? Like, was it laid out over a while? Or?
It was tricky because I did it myself, right? I didn't really go to any particular record company or management and say, you know, go and get me Rain or Nick Hexum from 311 or anything
right.
like that. It was all sort of very rootsy. I did it myself and I contacted the artists myself, and there was a lot of red tape to get through, but everybody really liked the music, so they wanted to contribute.
Yeah, that song's a huge hit. Like, The Edge plays it all the time.
The Grace is big.
You're
yes.
joining me right now, Steve and Luke from Hot Hot Heat. How's it going?
Excellent.
Very well.
Now, a couple of your songs appeared in video game releases. I know You Owe Me an IOU was in MVP Baseball. Picking It Up was in Madden. And Goodnight, Goodnight was in EA Sports Baseball. Are you guys going to do any of that before the album comes out so people might be able to hear some of these songs?
I don't know. I don't really know how it all works. I usually find out after the fact.
So you don't even know, you're just like playing video games and there's
yeah.
your song.
I just
always assumed that Steve's lyrics were all about sports and video games.
Well, that was
kind
of my main focus growing up, as you can tell by my physique.
Go ahead. Yeah, you're pretty built.
You fit in with a lot of the Edge staff members then, because they train vigorously playing video games.
I heard that, big thumbs.
Now, I know you guys have been in the studio since about, what, mid-May?
Yeah, we actually started our record and finished it in about 3 weeks.
Oh, so it's done already?
Yeah, it's completely finished.
How'd the sessions go? What was the process like?
We did it differently than any other record. We would start a song with drums in the morning and just finish the song by the end of the night. So we started a new song every day.
So you're just starting with the drums and layer the guitars and then write the vocals afterwards? Is that how it went?
Yeah, and just did the vocals at the very end of the night, usually late night. And so a lot of times you go into a studio and you do all the drums for every song first. And it's kind of like this, you know, factory process.